Hey everyone, this is Jerry with San Pedro Mastery. In this video, I will show you how to harvest a San Pedro fruit and how to clean its seeds. You have to wait until the fruit opens before you can harvest it. First, you remove the old dried flower in order to have better access to the fruit. Next, you scoop out the pulp with a spoon. Fruits can vary in size. A smaller fruit can contain just a few hundred seeds. A larger fruit, a few thousands. In this particular case, I would say this fruit contains about 2,500 seeds. Once you have finished scooping it, you will be left with an empty fruit shell. Leave it on the plant, it will eventually fall off after some time, which could be days, weeks, or months. It is important to harvest the fruit on the day it opens. Otherwise, insects will start to colonize it. If you don't harvest the fruit on the same day, you should still be okay as long as you clean the seeds thoroughly, like I'm going to show you in this video. However, don't leave the fruit sitting for too many days or black mold will start to appear. I don't personally use seeds that have been in contact with mold. I throw them away. If you do use them, make sure you clean and disinfect them really well, and then store them in a separate hermetic container from the rest of your seeds, mentioning on the label that they have been in contact with mold. Sometimes the fruit will fully open, like in this instance where it has the shape of a starfish. This makes it an easy-to-eat dish for birds who love to come and feast on it. I have seen fruits completely eaten by birds in just one day, and they didn't even leave one single seed. You just have to be first. Another method of collecting seeds is to pick up the entire fruit, including the outer shell. First, you get the wilted flower out of the way. Then you remove the fruit by twisting it. A few turns will do the trick. This is a method I use on flowers that are hard to access, but it does leave more of a scar than if you were to leave the skin on the plant and let it fall naturally. Now we're going to see how these seeds can be cleaned. The first step is going to mix them with water in a bowl. Tap water will do. Squeeze the flesh between your fingers and keep squeezing until the seeds are separated from the pulp. In the rest of this video, I will show you step by step how I clean my seeds, which by the way you can purchase, and I will talk about that at the very end of this video. Cleaning seeds thoroughly prevents you from having problems later on when the seeds are germinating. If you have bought seeds on the internet and they feel sticky to the touch, then that means they have not been washed and they should be washed before you sow them. It is not an absolute necessity to wash them, just like it's not an absolute necessity to sterilize the soil. But taking these steps reduces the risks of contamination and mold. The next step will take place over a sink. You place the seeds in a sieve, I use a plastic one, and you run some tap water on them in order to clean out the seeds further. With my fingers, I squeeze the seeds against the sieve, and some liquefied pulp will come out on the other side of the sieve. You have to squeeze them gently, because you don't want to crush the seeds. In that respect, I believe using a plastic sieve is much better than a metal one, which will be too abrasive. Do this for a while until the quantity of pulp has been greatly reduced. Of course, before you do all this, you must make sure that the screen of your sieve is fine enough and that the seeds will not pass through it. With the sieve I use, a very small percentage of seeds go through. They are the smallest seeds. But that's okay, since these very small seeds tend not to germinate anyway. Another point worth mentioning is that you probably don't want to open the water tap to the maximum, as the pressure can make your seeds fly over the sieve and you will lose them in the sink. You then lay the seeds flat on a piece of paper towel and you spread them all over the sheet. The idea is to spread them over as much of a surface as possible so that everything lays super flat. Then when it will dry, the seeds will come out with ease. If you don't spread them enough, then the seeds will be trapped inside some lumps of hardened pulp and it may be very difficult to free them. There will be some seeds stuck to your hand. You can wipe them off with another paper towel. Then you lay that paper towel on top of the other one and you press on it gently. Then you peel it off and that will have flattened some more the lumps of pulp. I recommend you repeat the process with one or two more sheets of paper towel. Like this, you will have the seeds spread very flat. And when they are dry, they will separate very easily from the dried pulp. After a few hours or in the next morning, the paper towel should be very dry. You can collect the seeds in a plate. Many of them will come out without any effort. Others that are still glued to the paper towel will come out with a bit of scratching. Scratch them off with your thumb or if need be with your nails. What I like to do afterwards is transfer them a few times from a clean plate to another clean plate. Every time you do that, the seeds will leave behind some pulp dust. You want a minimum of that dust. Afterward, you could also rinse the seeds again under the tap to further reduce the presence of plant dust, although this step is optional. Now I'm pouring some hydrogen peroxide onto the seeds, the typical 3% solution that you can buy in pharmacies. I use it neat, straight out of the bottle. Another option is to wash the seeds with water and dishwashing liquid. No doubt the peroxide method is excellent at disinfecting the seeds. But the added bonus is that it separates seeds from any bits of gluey pulp that may still be attached to them. You can see the seeds fizzling in the peroxide. However, do not leave it for too long, about 30 seconds to a minute. Immediately afterwards, I rinse the seeds thoroughly. Rinse your fingers at the same time, as the peroxide can burn them a bit. Now you dry the seeds again on a paper towel. They will dry very fast as they don't have any more pulp attached to them. Whatever fruit pulp is left has been whitened by the peroxide. You can remove these white bits or you can sew them together with the seeds. I don't think it matters. Once the seeds are dry, you can either sew them right away or you can store them in a glassine envelopes and place it inside an airtight jar together with a very small bag of silica gel. Do not use a large bag of silica gel as it could dry the air too much. Make sure you place it somewhere dark, like in a cupboard, and like this they should keep for years, although they will lose a bit of viability every year. All the San Pedro and peyote seeds that I produce and sell have been properly washed like in this video. This way you won't have to wash them yourself and you can just sow them as is. But getting properly washed seeds is just one of the points to keep in mind when you are on the lookout for seeds. It is also very important that the seeds are fresh, as this will dictate their germination rate. But most importantly, that the seeds are the species and strain they are advertised to be. And to be sure of that, they must have been hand-pollinated with the flowers enclosed in pollination bags. I highly recommend you watch my video, Why Most San Pedro Seeds Are a Rip-Off, so that you familiarize yourself with these essential points. It's only a short video. This is it for this video. If you enjoyed it, please hit like. This is actually another way you can support this channel. Also, don't forget to subscribe and tick the notification bell so that you don't miss all my future San Pedro and peyote videos. I'll see you girls and guys again very soon.